When your father dies in Irish, you lose your umbrella against bad weather. May his son be your light, say the Armenians. When your father dies, say the Welsh, you sink a foot deeper into the earth. May you inherit his light, say the Armenians. When your father dies, say the Canadians, you run out of excuses. May you inherit his son, say the Armenians. When your father dies, say the French, you become your own father. You stand up in his light, say the Armenians. When your father dies, say the Indians, he comes back as thunder. May you inherit his light, say the Armenians. When your father dies, say the Russians, he takes your childhood with him. May you inherit his light, say the Armenians. When your father dies, say the English, you join his club you vowed you never would. May you inherit his son, say the Armenians. When your father dies, say the Armenians, your son shifts forever, and you walk in his light. Every night when you got home from work, I would jump from the top stair into your arms, and never doubting your ability to catch me, always finding comfort in your embrace. Every night we would walk to the park and trace our fingertips along each constellation, never neglecting to mention one we named, always losing track of time. Every night we would read Justice League comic books in bed because I was too afraid to sleep alone. Never forgetting the monsters under my bed, but always knowing you would protect me better than any superhero could. Rituals so sacred, they were never delayed, always obeyed, but I guess rituals are made to decay because in fifth grade, I learned how to spell glioblastoma. G-L-I-O-B-L-A-S-T-O-M-A, glioblastoma. I learned that instead of jumping into your arms, my hugs would have to be gentle, that instead of walks to the park, we would take walks to the hospital cafeteria, that instead of comic books in bed, I would have to learn to sleep alone. But we made new rituals more sacred than those of the past, but I guess no ritual has to last, because when I finally asked, I learned that glioblastoma meant cancer. But I did not learn that your life had now been stamped with an expiration date, that within a year I would come home from dance class to a street full of cars, I would push open the unlocked door, the house would beep, and the beep would hush every whisper into a silence, but the beep would remind me that I didn't hear the oxygen. That was the last moment before everything shifted. The sun, the stars, the moon, our rituals. Because when your father dies, he takes your childhood with him. And when your mother mouths the words, he's gone and run. Run away from her words and run to you. I jumped onto your bed, but your arms didn't catch me. I embraced you, but I found no comfort. I knew you could battle monsters better than any superhero could, but I guess cancer was an exception. After your funeral, they told me to be strong, so I buried my feelings 6 feet under, false smiles, and swallowed tears, but you can only swallow so many tears before you begin to drown. That night, I replaced dear God with dear Dad, because no God that ever took your life could ever deserve my prayers, and no one could be more deserving of my prayers than you. Dear Dad, I'm sorry. Sorry for every time I forgot a thank you. Sorry for every time I got mad at you. Sorry for every time I didn't say I love you. Dear Dad, I love you. And I miss you, and I wish I spent more time with you. And dear Dad, I'm scared. Not of monsters or the dark, but scared because it's been 6 years, and in six more I have lived the same amount of time without you as I did with you. And dear Dad, even when you couldn't get out of bed or even talk, when the cancer had taken the last of your strength, leaving you just barely hanging on, I would come into your room at night to say I love you, and you'd whisper back, I love you too. Dear Dad, that was our most sacred ritual. Dear Dad, I love you.